Hey Campoholics, today we're going to install the Lippert Thin Shade. Here we go.
I'm Missy.
I'm Mike.
And we're the Campoholics!
See me now? Alright, let's see what else we got in here. We got the frame, the window frame, the instructions. Yeah.
So,
I just gotta figure out how.
All we need
to pop off the old one
is this part. This one right here. Yeah, this is really ticking him off. He has to read directions. Not happy. Doesn't like it.
Mm-mm.
So do you want to explain why we're having to do that? Like what happened?
No, you explain.
Oh my gosh, you're such a... When I was putting the thin shade, moving it around... Ooh, there's sticky stuff. This broke. So that means the thin shade won't stay. So we contacted Lippert, and the only way to get this piece fixed is just to replace this entire inside piece. We don't need to replace the outside piece, just the inside piece.
But yes, we just got to figure out. Stop! Don't break it! Don't break it!
You pushed it
together,
which you're probably not supposed to do.
Don't break it!
You're
right, we got to figure out how to take that thing apart.
You pushed it together when you took it out.
Okay. All right, let's figure this out. All right, guys, and the kit comes with these removal tools, they call it, in a kit. And what you have to do is, on this particular unit, this is not screwed on. So you need the removal tools to do it. You find your gaps, like so, and you slide your stuff in there. There's so many gaps around here. That and just go around the perimeter of the window looking for these little gaps, and you slide the window removal tools in there. Alright guys, so once you get these clips inserted in the old window all the way around, and this is my last one, this is supposed to pop out. Missy's on the other side to ensure the glass doesn't fall out on the other side, which it shouldn't because it's heavily caulked, siliconed, whatever it is. So this is going to be my attempt to pop this off. I'm going to have to let go of the camera to do so, but we'll see what happens. Frame off. I will tell you, it took some effort to pry it out with the a flathead screwdriver. See, there's a mark right there. But hopefully when you slip the other one directly right back on once we put the install the thin shade. So it's no big deal. What's bad is it makes a terrible noise with the plastic frame. You think you're breaking the whole thing, you think it's going to shatter in pieces, but just with some effort it pops off. So hopefully I can pop the new one on and reuse this other side, since it's already caulked up and I won't have to re-caulk and all that stuff. So we'll find out. We're going to experiment it for you. All right, we got a new frame ready to go on here. It does not indicate a top or a bottom. Missy's saying it's the same universal, whatever. So hopefully all I have to do is pop this right back in place and the old piece will grab the new piece and everything will line up and it will work.
If it doesn't,
we're screwed on a Sunday afternoon with no window. All right, we got it on. It's ideal that the person on the other side has their hand center of the frame, I think, and you push against each other and it merely just snaps right back in place. Work around it to make sure you got a tight fit, but fortunately for us, we did not have to take the other side off because it is already caulked. So we just merely replaced that one side. So it worked out. Now we're going to hang the thin shade. So Missy hung it up.
Same. It's, everybody assumes it's upside down, but honestly, there's no difference whatsoever. We do it this way because then I can
create a peephole.
You can see out.
Yes, you can see
out. If you do it this way.
If you do it that way.
If you never plan on opening it, then that's fine. But then your peephole is here.
Yes. So we reverse it so we can see out.
And we have
in a standing position. You don't have to bend over to look outside. That's what we're trying to do.
And we have a pet
pet alarm
tag.
Call us in the event of emergency.
So we can leave that up there, still see out, and still get some.
All right, show them how you put it in there. All right, guys, Missy's about to install the thin shade. Again, we're going to reverse it just to make it more accessible to us to see outside. So how do you install the
So you open up your tabs to the unlocked position,
and then you'll put this, they grasp in this track. There's a track on the top or bottom. I guess this technically is the top because it does have the springs. That's the only difference. I don't know if you can see that or not.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But what I did with the last one that we had was I popped these ends out and I made the tension like a little bit shorter, a little tighter. Just depends on if you're...
That's only if you want to flip it.
Yeah, if you want to flip it.
So you already did that?
So, no, I didn't. I don't have to do anything with it. We're fine.
Okay. All right.
But if it won't stay up.
Oh, if it won't stay
sometimes
up.
Sometimes it won't stay up, you need to shorten the strings.
Okay.
So just pop this in. Up top there. And then you pull these tabs over. But I'm going to wait and do it till I get it in there. Go in, and then you'll flip that one. Now I'm gonna tell you right now, these went 100% easier than the last one. The last ones I had to use a set of pliers.
Oh.
And then you'll put this one in. That's how I broke it, and that, so it is in. And there is your thin shade. So that's exactly what happened. My last ones, I couldn't use finger strength. I had to use a set of pliers, and when I did, I broke that thing off.
Okay.
So this must be much better. So we keep ours just about right there.
Uh-huh.
And we have this. Hold, please.
We'll show our phone numbers. People might try to call us.
Yeah.
We have this. The other side has our phone numbers on it, and we hang it right here. So they can see that when they walk up to the door, and then we still have visual to see out.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and we actually can close it all the way, even with that in there. And the only time we ever do that is for sun. Because unless somebody's coming up to the door like this.
Yeah. And this is what it looks like when it's half down. I mean, again, we can control the eyesight. So, again, you don't have to bend down to look outside. You can stay right up here, look here, and adjust it to the height that you would like when you flip it upside down. All right, thanks for watching. We'll see you next video. Bye-bye.